Hi team, recording has been started. So in today's session, what we'll see is how we can hit Angular, how we can hit an API layer through Angular, right? What we have to do or how we have to write the code or what exactly we need to, you know, do in the code so that our Angular, you know, will be able to hit the APIs, correct? So we'll be hitting the APIs, from APIs we'll fetch the data. Data will come in the services. From services, it should come to component. From component, it should show to HTML, correct? So we'll see the complete flow that how from the Angular, we will hit the API, fetch the data and show it on the browser, correct? So let's finish this part first. So I am already having one sample Angular project and I have already created, right? APIs basically. So I already have APIs. So APIs are there in server.js file. Correct. We have two sort of APIs here. We have two endpoints here basically, not sort of, two endpoints here. So one endpoint is slash products, correct? And one endpoint is slash users. So we have two APIs, two endpoints basically, which we will be hitting from Angular and showing the data, fetching the data first and showing it on screen, right, on HTML. So let's see how we can do that, right? So for that, first let's go to our Angular layer. So we have app folder, open app folder, you will find app component. By default, you know, one component we have, right? So what we do is, let's add one more component, okay? So what is the command to add a component? Any idea how we can add component dynamically?
So, ng-gc.
Exactly. So the command to add a new component is ng. Ng means Angular. So we are saying, hey, Angular, g for generate. Generate what? C. C means component. So C is a short form of component. G is a short form of, generate. So I'm saying ng-gc, which means I'm saying, hey, Angular, g for generate. Generate what? C for component, right? Followed by component name. So what is my component name? I want to show the product list. So I say product. NGGC product. So what it says is that, you know, I don't have the proper system rights basically to, you know, fire the command from here. So no worries, that's not an issue. So what you can do is, you can directly, you know, open this project. I mean, you can open your command prompt, right? And from command prompt, you can, you know, fire the command. If let's say your Visual Studio code is not working, right? What you can do is, if the Visual Studio command prompt or terminal is not working, then you can open the command prompt. Okay? So command prompt open the script. So what you do to open a command prompt is, you go to the file path. Correct. Either you can directly open it from here, say cmd and enter. So it will open, the command prompt will open from that path itself. So you can see I am inside my application, right? My first app. Correct. And from here, I would say, I'm inside my folder. So I say ng-gc product. Now it should generate a component by name product. Where? Under app folder by default. So yes. So you can see it has added a product component, correct, in my project. So you can see what it has done. It has added one HTML file, one spec.ts, which means a test unit test file, one TS file, correct, one component, I mean to say, and one SES file. SES file means SCSS. These are preprocessors. You can say style sheets. For now, you consider it style sheets, correct? And at the same time, it has updated my app.model also. So why it has updated the app.module? So if you go to app.module, this one, so it has added an entry, correct? In my module file, it has added an entry that you have a new component in the list, correct? Samajh mein aaya, clear hua hai? When you add a component, basically, the component get added, but one entry will go to your module file also. Team, you understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Nishu, Reva.
Yes.
आप कभी भी कोई नया component डालते हो या pipe डालते हो या directive डालते हो जैसे आगे आप देखोगे, so क्या होता है कि उसकी एक entry जो है वो app module में चली जाती है. App module मतलब तुम्हारी header file. As I said in the start, your Angular application will have one, at least one parent module, correct? Right? And then it can have further modules as well. But ek parent module hoga hi hoga. It will have one parent module, correct? So that parent module is always going to be your app module. I repeat one more time. Your parent module is always going to be your app module, correct? Iske andar hi, in this app module only, you will have further submodules. Okay? So sabse badi header file kaun hai? App.module.ts. इसके अंदर तुम्हारी और मॉड्यूल फाइल होंगी जैसे कोनियो स्टूडियो राइट लाइक दैट. यू गॉट माय पॉइंट? यस नो?
यस सर.
जैसे मैंने कोनियो स्टूडियो क्यों बोला, जैसे आपके C++ में कोनियो स्टूडियो ये हेडर फाइल्स होती है, करेक्ट? सिमिलरली हमारा ऐप मॉड्यूल भी एक तरह का हेडर फाइल समझो. इफ यू वांटेड टू मैप इट विद C++, सो कंसीडर your app.module file is also like your header file, main header file. Iske andar aapki jo hai baki inbuilt files honge, correct? Inside that only you will have other inbuilt modules, correct? Or inbuilt, correct? Or predefined packages, right? Agar aapne dekhna hai to aap you can check this. In your app module you are having your product, sorry, you are having your ng module, see? You are having your browser module, see? These are predefined modules, correct? Right? So your ng module will have all kinds of basically predefined modules, right? This is your parent module. Okay, let's move from here. So now next thing is, once you added a component, you can see a product component is here. See, our product component here, correct? Now what you do is you wanted to use this component. So to use this component, you need to call it somewhere. जैसे आपने class बनाया C++ में, sorry, not C. So if you create a class, you have to instantiate it. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right? If you create a class, you need to instantiate it. So consider your product is your class. And now you need to instantiate it. इसको call नहीं करोगे तो ये it will not come into existence. So जो मैंने product component बनाया है, now I need to call it. So how I will be calling it? There are two ways of calling it. One is dynamically and another one is statically. Correct? In a static way. One is in a dynamic way. Second one is in a static way. So dynamic way means I'm calling the component dynamically by its class name. ठीक है? मतलब मेरा जो component है product component, इसकी class क्या है? Again, class name क्या है? Product component. So एक तरीका तो ये है कि मैं product component को dynamically call करूँ. मतलब मैं अपने component को class wise call करूँ dynamically. Second way is इसको statically call किया जाए. इसकी static call के लिए we use the selector. So now, do you understand what is selector? Do you know what is selector? Selector क्या होता है? Any idea?
Sir, जो इस particular component का एक reference होता है एक तरीके का.
Selector का कोई और example बता सकते हो? Existing example, Nishu और Reva. Can you tell me any existing example of selector? Vishu, Reva, अच्छा HTML में सिलेक्टर कौन क्या होते हैं? What are selectors in HTML?
सर क्लास एन आई डी
व्हाट वन
क्लास एन आई डी
एक्चुअली क्लास सिलेक्टर आई डी सिलेक्टर ओके एंड एनी अदर वे
सर पैराग्राफ टैग्स हेडिंग टैग्स
उसको क्या बोलते हैं
सर टैग्स ही बोल सेलेक्टर्स ही बोलेंगे
टैग नेम्स
यस सर
टैग नेम ओके सो यहां पर ये क्या है टैग नेम है एलिमेंट नेम है ठीक है सो एड हाइफन प्रोडक्ट इज अ एलिमेंट नेम ऑफ योर प्रोडक्ट कंपोनेंट जैसे आपने बोला ना अभी जस्ट नाउ यू सेड पी टैग डिव टैग बटन टैग इनपुट टैग सो ये प्री डिफाइंड सेलेक्टर्स है या प्री डिफाइंड यू नो एलिमेंट नेम है एलिमेंट्स है राइट Predefined selectors हैं और user defined selectors कौन से हुए जैसे for example this now this product component is user defined you know user defined element or user defined you know selector ठीक है ना clear है this is user defined team is it clear or not
yes sir
Nishu, Reva, is it clear or not?
Yes, sir. Now it is clear.
Now it is clear. So, अब मुझे अगर तो statically call करना है, तो मैं ये selector use करूँगा. कैसे? I want to call it on app component, right? वैसे भी अगर मैं इसे call नहीं करूँगा, so it is not going to get called. So products और यहां पर मैं selector call करता हूं right I'm calling product component by its selector name agree is it clear
yes sir
yes sir
okay. now if I run this अगर मैं इसको run करता हूं तो run the project what is the command npm start So when you say npm start or ng serve, your project basically runs it, right? It's compiling. So my server is going to, you know, start. My Angular project is going to start. And your app component is a default, you know, default component, your default base component. ओके ऐप कंपोनेंट आपका डिफॉल्ट बेस कंपोनेंट होगा सारे कंपोनेंट्स एग्जैक्टली उसी में लोड होंगे ओके सो ये मेरा कंपाइल हो गया यू कैन सी इट गॉट कंपाइल्ड सक्सेसफुली नाउ आई नीड टू रन द प्रोजेक्ट सो टू रनिंग द प्रोजेक्ट इट शुड बी रनिंग एट लोकल होस्ट 4200 लाइक दिस See, product came, right? To just be double sure, let me just show you what I'm talking about. So you can see your products, see, H1 products and app products is the component that I call by its selector name. So you can see it is printing product works. So if you go to product.component.html so here it is written product works right so if I say list of products and you know save it So this will also reply back list of products. You understood this point or not? Is it clear or not? Team, is it clear or not? Hello? Hello?
No, sir.
So which part is not clear? Tell me. Nishu. So you see, you are inside the product component, correct? It's HTML. So if I, you know, print a table. And say, whatever I do in HTML, you will see, correct? You will see it on the browser, correct? So this product dot, okay. I repeat one more time. So if you see app component.html, in your app component.html, which is your base component, in that I have called your product component, correct, by its element name, right? As I told you, that app component